Hi, this is a challenge problem and we will determine to master the skill of completing squares using this problem. Firstly, please remember that in order to apply completing squares technique, we must have the coefficient of x square to be 1. In this case, the coefficient of x square is observed to be 3. We will make it 1 by dividing the x square term by 3. Always remember that to keep the equation equivalent to the original one, whatever you do to one term, you must do to all the terms of the equation. So now, we will divide the whole equation by 3, which means we divide every term of the equation by 3, and that gives 3x squared divided by 3 is x squared minus 5x divided by 3 plus 1 divided by 3, which is equal to 0 divided by 3. 0 divided by any non-zero number is 0. So we have x squared minus 5/3 of x plus 1/3 is 0 itself. The next step is to keep the binomial having x squared term and the x term on one side and move the constant term to the other side. And that gives x squared minus 5x divided by 3 is equal to negative 1/3. Now we will find the number that must be added to both sides of the equation so that left-hand side can be made a perfect square. Here are the steps to find that magic number. Take the coefficient of x term. So the coefficient of x term you can observe is negative 5/3. Divide that number by 2. So that would be negative 5/3 divided by 2, which will be negative 5/3 times the reciprocal, and that gives you negative 5/6. Now you take that number and square it up, which is negative 5/6 being squared. Let's keep it the way it is right now. So this is the magic number that has to be added to both sides of this equation. So we will have x squared minus 5/3 of x plus that magic number equals negative 1/3 plus that same magic number. Once we have done this, we know how to write a perfect square out of this left-hand side. And what is that? We want a perfect square. We will take this base, x, and add to that this base, and so that would be negative 5/6 there. So the left hand side is a perfect square of x minus 5/6. If you try to do that squaring, which is multiplying x minus 5/6 twice, you will end up having the left hand side as you see in this equation. and that will be equal to right hand side will be negative 1/3 plus, when you square negative 5/6, you are going to get negative square is positive, 5 square is 25 divided by 6 square is 36. And you want to take the common denominator 36. And how do you get that? By multiplying 3 by 12. And what you do to the denominator, you do to the numerator also. And so you will have negative 12 plus 25, which is 13. And at the bottom, it is 36 in both cases of the fractions. So we have the equation to be such a perfect square equation. Now we solve this by taking square root on both sides, and we will get x minus 5/6 on the left hand side, and on the right hand side it would be positive root or negative root of 13 divided by 36. We will try to simplify that right hand side. We can break it up as plus or minus root 13 divided by root 36. We know 13 cannot be factored any further. It is a prime, and so it has to just sit there under that radical. But 36 is 6 times 6, so square root of 36 would be 6 itself. Now we will isolate x by adding 5/6 to both sides of the equation. So we will, let me write the equation here. And add 5/6 to both sides. And that gives me x is equal to 5/6 added to plus or minus root 13 divided by 6. And we can write that as a solution set. So the solution set for the equation that we started with, which is 3x squared minus 5x plus 1 equal to 0, is put it within the set brackets, and the solutions are 5 plus root 13 divided by 6 and 5 minus root 13 divided by 6. I hope this helps. Thank you.